When Jessica Louie and her husband opted for online schooling for their two boys, they were hoping to give their family some peace of mind. But with this option came other stresses.
I don't have a teacher.
Louie's oldest son is still waiting for his first day of online school.
He was so disappointed. He's like, I don't have a teacher. I don't have a course. I don't have assignment. What does it mean by independent learning?
You need a teacher, right?
Another Toronto family, same story.
We couldn't log in. So again, it took me 40 minutes. When we did log in, he doesn't have a teacher yet.
Kids still without classes or teachers is another blow to families in the school board that has already delayed the start of its online school year twice. Most recently, it was because many families made a last-minute jump to e-learning.
I believe that it should have started from March, having a concrete plan how to go forward for September, and I think they just waited too long to get that ball rolling.
We did not anticipate that significant a change. We knew, obviously, we were going to get tens of thousands of students, but 78,000 students by total enrollment is actually larger than most school boards in Ontario.
There are other challenges as well.
Note in the chat.
This teacher says he didn't experience any technical difficulties, but many of his colleagues did, with a software mandated by the government.
Many people are struggling with that steep technological learning curve and having to layer that learning process on top of all their other responsibilities and the other complexities of teaching.
But this hurdle and many others will have to be overcome, as the number of students in online courses will likely only grow alongside Ontario's infection numbers. The next date for elementary students attending in person to switch to online is right after Thanksgiving. The board says all current online students should have their teachers assigned by the end of this week. Deanna Sumanac-Johnson, CBC News, Toronto.